మీనాక్షి ఫ్యాకల్టీ ఆఫ్ క్యాటరింగ్ అండ్ హోటల్ మేనేజ్మెంట్ వలసరవాకం చెన్నై అడ్మిషన్స్ ఓపెన్ ఫర్ బిఎస్సీ కోర్సెస్ అప్లై నౌ
రీ లుకింగ్ ఫర్ ఆల్ యువర్ హెయిర్ అండ్ స్కిన్ రిలేటెడ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ది బెస్ట్ సొల్యూషన్ క్లినిక్ ఉడనడియా విజిట్ పనుగ అమేజింగ్ ఆన్ ఎక్స్‌పీరియన్స్ పెరుంగ
కమింగ్ టు యూత్ యాక్టింగ్ విత్ విజయ్ సర్ హౌ వాస్ ఇట్ హౌ యు హౌ యు గైస్ వేర్ డ్యూరింగ్ దట్ టైం
I mean, see, back then I didn't know like he was such a huge star. When I signed the film, I knew like, okay, Vijay, he's like a very famous actor here. I mean, there was no social media back then. I didn't really watch movies down there so much. So I was a model from Bombay, but I just knew like, okay, he's kind of big here. And when I worked with him, also, I mean, he never had that attitude that oh, I'm like a big star or a celebrity. He was always so grounded, like so down to earth, so simple. I never got that feeling of I'm working with a youth star.
And now, after 20 years, he's grown so much as an actor. He's become huge.
On social media, I keep seeing like I think he's one of the biggest actors with so many fan pages. And you know, having said that, his fans are so loyal, and he's really big. And now I see that. So, like, you know how, because we are more aware with social media, what is going around, what is happening around us. Back then, you had no idea, like, you know, how people are thinking and what they're thinking. But now, yes. So he is really big. Yes.
Can you just recall any conversations which you had with Vijay sir?
I think we were very cordial with each other. It was always about, you know, I mean, he would come on the sets ready for the scene. He would just not make me feel uncomfortable that I'm new. And he was always very kind, smiling. I don't really remember any conversation as such, because I think he's also an introvert. And I was also back then quite into my shell. So we never really spoke so much. You know, basic, we did our work on the sets and that's it. Hi, hello, and have exchange, you know, pleasantries, and that's it.
So, what kind of role you wanted to do if Vijay sir, you're pairing opposite Vijay sir?
Right. I think you know. I mean, basically, it's the story. You know, the story has to be important, and your role should make a difference. It should be important. It shouldn't be like, you know, you just come and just go. Like something meaningful, something nice. You know, for starters.
So when is the last time you spoke to him? If you can recall that,
when we were shooting. I mean,
only
I
that. The last, only then.
Yes. So I never made friends really with any of my. You know, I was not very social. Where I worked and that's it. My co actors or my production team or everybody was just work. And then once it was over, it was over. Except for one from my first movie, the assistant director Sai. I've been in touch with him because he always helped me so much with the language and the way he made me understand, you know, because the very first movie, it was very difficult, suddenly a different language. But he was so helpful that I used to say my lines so well and, you know, learn them so well, even, you know, for the lip sync or for everything. So I think, you know, my spot boy and the assistant director, these are the only two people I've stayed in touch with.
Still remember you as Sandhya. The Tamil audience. So it's been 20 years, almost 20 years. Yeah. So still we can connect you. We can connect to you as Sandhya. So how is this?
I think I'm really fortunate for that, because I mean, as you said, it's been so many years and people still remember me as Sandhya. And I think the movie had such a great impact that I still have all my fans and everybody has the same question. Ma'am, you look the same. Like even 20 years back, you were the same. Even now you're the same. And when are you coming back? So I guess it's a blessing to do such a good film. And I'll always be proud of it.
And you did the same film in three different languages. So how did you... wasn't it difficult, because you have to differentiate every time you have to do something different?
See, I guess it all depends on your director also. The character was the same, the storyline was the same. I was the same in all the movies, except for my co-stars changed, my production houses. I think I would give credit to the directors to make me, you know, give my best in all the films, all three of them in all three different languages.
So acting happened and you did only 5 films. Timeline was very little. Was that a conscious decision? What happened actually?
I don't know what happened actually. The movies did very well. Even Chirunaguthu did very well. Even, you know, I don't know so much about the Kannada film. I do think that also did well. And of course, Youth did very well. But, you know, back then I was from Bombay. I used to be homesick if I used to be away from here for very long. So that was one of the factors where I felt like, no, you know, I want to be in Bombay and I want to work here and I'm happy doing advertising. So I guess when you're young and when you're like, you know, you make certain decisions probably which later you feel, no, why did I do that? I could have done, you know, some more good work. But back then I was like, no, I think it's good enough and I want to be back to Bombay and living there.
Okay, so you regret that decision a bit now?
A little bit. I feel like, you know, I mean, I did such a nice film and it became such a big hit and I could have done some more good films with some, you know, different directors and actors. And but I guess it's all destiny. End of the day, maybe that was it. And so that's it. I don't know.
Okay. It's a hypothetical question again. What kind of roles you're looking forward? Like, which role can interest you if you're like, giving a comeback?
I would always want to do like a good character, or I would still want to be the main lead. I just believe age is just a number. You have, if the heroes can be the heroes, why can't the actresses be the main character even after so many, you know, years or age? Or, and over the years things have changed, you know, things are changing. There are characters written according to your age and the way you look. It's all about casting you for the right role. So even if I come back, it really has to be something really worth it for me to want to come back and do it. The role, yeah, it really matters.
So coming back to the soundtrack, each and every song was super hit in the movie. You do you remember Sakkare Nilave?
I do.
It is still so popular.
I don't understand the language so much. Like I knew the basic meaning and lyrics, but the music used to be so soothing that I actually enjoyed every song. Like even though I wouldn't understand like the language completely, but with the music and I really enjoyed the songs and I still do.
So what did you think when people came and approached you to a Tamil film? What was running in your mind?
I mean, see, I was first. I did the Telugu film Chirunaguthu, which is Youth is the remake of that film.
Yeah.
So when I was modeling over here, I was pretty big with my advertising, and I was pretty like known over here, doing very well. So when they offered me over there, I wasn't really ready suddenly. But the people were so nice and, you know, they really convinced me that it's a very good film. And I always wanted to do clean work and the kind of work I can sit and watch with my family and enjoy. So it was one of those kind of movies. And I said yes. And when Chirunaguthu did so well, they offered me, you know, the Tamil one and the Kannada one. I was more than happy to do it.
Wow. I told you, like, people here still remember you as Sandhya. And we love you as Sandhya. So, can you share any memories which you had with Tamil audience? So
I think the Tamil audience is very loyal to you know, people they like, and your fans are really loyal to you. Even my spot boy, like you know, so he's always been in touch with me till he was my spot boy in all the movies. In all the 5 movies, and after so many years also, he always remembers to wish me on my birthdays, Eid, any occasion. We always, you know, stay connected. So I think it's the people. They're very simple, very nice people.
Thank you. I would take the compliment representing them.
It is true. Totally.
Again, coming back to social media, there are few negativities spreading over social media.
That's right.
Does that affect you, or you're observing that negativity, or how do you just take it?
I'm lucky. I don't have any such, you know, people trolling me or any such comments on social media, because as I said, my account was private for very long. But even when I see other people doing it on, you know, somebody else's Instagram page or handle, I always feel why, like, you know, why the negativity? It's their life. Whoever wants to do whatever, we are nobody to judge anyone. So to each his own. It's nice to be positive and if say nice things. And if you can't, you don't have to say something.
So before you leave, were you offered any Tamil films which you refused to do or which you couldn't take up?
Not before, just when I left, not immediately, there were offers, but I wasn't sure how good they were. So I don't really remember any. There was another film which I signed, and again, that didn't take off. But after I came back to Bombay, and then I started modeling, and again, after some time, I did get offered one or two, but then I was getting married, so I decided to quit working.
Okay, so just again, reminding your life, how was Shaheen when she was a school kid? What was her mindset? What was happening with her?
Shaheen was a very, very, very shy girl. If any of my friends or family who knew me, they would never think I would be a model or an actor, because I was such a shy person. Even to talk to people, it would really take a lot of effort, and I was totally in my shell, a total introvert. Okay. I've changed a lot over the years.
So your schooling was in Bombay only?
My schooling was in Bombay. Totally. Pakka, I've lived in Bombay in my life.
Pakka Bombay girl.
Pakka Bombay girl. Pakka Bandra girl. You know, in Bombay, you know.
This area called Bandra. Bandra, yeah.
So it's like I can say I'm a total Bandra girl.
So while school, you being a school girl, you said you were very introvert. What was that one point that made you choose modeling? And I think that decision is a turning point in your life, I suppose. So was that influenced or was...
I don't know. It just happened. I went to college after my school. And when I was in college, I used to get a lot of offers for modeling. But I would say no, like, you know, no, I can't and I won't do it. But over the years, I guess I just became more confident and more. So I said, okay, let me give it a shot. I did my portfolio from Dabbu Ratnani. And the very first time I took my pictures to a production house to give it to them, they offered me an ad commercial. So I was like, wow, this is so easy. Like, I didn't have to struggle. I did the ad film, and then I said there was no stopping. I got a lot of work after that. So I think I'm grateful, you know, for things to be so easy in life.
So after that acting happened, after that, the marriage decision, I think the yet another important decision of your life. So how did that happen?
So I guess, you know, once you've had your career, you've done everything in your life you wanted to. So I tasted my success. I had a good career for a good span of, I could say, I modeled for almost like 7 to 8 years and then 2 years of films down south. So I was pretty content, and I said, okay, next step is to have a family. And it was kind of arranged. And of course, I mean, initially it was arranged, and then I fell in love and I said yes. That's when I said yes, once I was in love, and we got married.
So after that, how is life after marriage?
Life has always been great. You know, whatever I've done in life, I've always been happy. My husband is a great person. I have a beautiful daughter, 11-year-old daughter, Sarah. And it was my decision.
She was the one who helped you with the...
She's the smart one. She's the tech-savvy one.
Oh, my God. Okay.
I am too naive with all these things. You know, I'm not the tech-savvy one. She's the one. So, yes, that's my daughter. And it was a conscious decision to not work after marriage and give a lot of time to my family, especially when, you know, my daughter was small. So I think I was more than happy in whatever decision I'm taking.
How is it to be a mother? How responsible are you feeling?
I'm an obsessive mother. So I'm always worrying. My life revolves around my daughter. I think it's the most beautiful thing God can bless you with, to have a child of your own and to be a mother. So I'm enjoying motherhood as much as I can say more than I enjoyed anything else in my life. And I was very happy to give up my career or work for my child. I think it's all worth it.
So Dashi knew about you, your body of work and all?
Yeah, like she's always been like, you know, boisterous with her friends. Oh, my mother was a model. Oh, my mother was an actor. So the girls keep coming and they watch on YouTube, her friends and everything. And they come and they're like, auntie, you were an actor. And, you know, we saw you on TV. So still some of the ads and music videos and even the film songs. They watch, and she wants me to get back to working. She's like, why did you quit? You shouldn't have quit, you know. Even so, what if I was there? Like, and she always pushes me, Mama, come on, you can still work, go back to working. And I'm like, I think I'm still not ready.
So you're not ready to give a comeback?
Not, I mean, see, I told you, I never planned things. They just happened. So I've never thought of coming back. But yes, of course, if something really nice, maybe today she's 11, she's grown up, I can get some time off, you know, maybe if there's something really nice, I will consider.
Are you watching Tamil movies or generally? I think you watch Hindi movies and all.
I do.
So whose work you're enjoying? Who's your favorite?
Hindi movies also. I like more of English movies. Hindi movies I do watch. Tamil movies not so much, but yes, I keep seeing a little trailers here and there or some song, like, you know, that way. But no particular person. Vijay, because I've worked with him, so I do see, like, you know, the kind of work he's doing and the kind of fame he's getting, and I'm happy for him because I've worked with him. So somewhere that little connect is there where you feel good about you know, your core star or somebody doing so well in life. It always makes you feel happy.
So over the years, industry has developed so much, evolved. But still, personally, what is the one thing you wanted the industry to change, or you helps in the betterment of the industry?
So I always initially felt back then where only the hero of the film was given so much importance and the credit was never shared with the actress as much. The roles were specifically written for the male lead, not so much for the female lead. But now times have changed already and this is happening. So both are getting equal importance. There is no gender bias as such, so much as of now. So I think that somewhere I always felt needed a little change and it's happened now. So I think it's good, you know.
No big complaints.
No big complaints, really. I have had good experiences with everybody. No bad experience ever in my life with my modeling or, you know, with films. So I guess I only have nice things to say.
Nice rewind about your life, which you shared with us. Thank you so much for your time. And as your daughter requested, as the Tamil fans requested, we would like to see you back.
That's right.
And even not in not at least in the, like, if you aren't still comfortable with the big screen, OTTs are becoming the boom now. At least we could see you.
So true. Definitely.
Thank you so much. Thank you for your time.
Pleasure talking to you and reviving old memories.
Thank you. The same here. Yeah. Bye.
Tara, behind a short film contest ee varsham undo?
Behind a short film contest indha varsham kedaiyadhu. But adukku badhila behind its gold movie challenge abindra oru vishayam pudusa pandranga.
Movie challenge ah? Abina
edukra oru oru padamo 65 nimishathukku mela kandipa irukanuma.
65 nimishathukku melaya?
Aamaanda, idhu short film illa la.
Seri, appo eduthuta.
Exciting ana cash prizes irukku. First prize 10 lakhs, second prize 5 lakhs, third prize 3 lakhs.
Wow!
இது மட்டும் இல்ல, இது தவிர ஸ்பெஷல் மென்ஷன் அப்படினு சொல்லி 10 பேரை செலக்ட் பண்ணி அவங்களுக்கு 2 lakhs கேஷ் கொடுக்குறாங்க.
அப்போ டோட்டலி 13 அவார்டா?
Yes, 13 பேருக்கு எக்ஸைட்டிங் ஆன கேஷ் பிரைசஸ் இருக்கு. கிளம்பறியா?
எடுக்குறோம்.
அவன் எடுக்கிறது இருக்கட்டும். உங்களுக்கு இத பத்தி மேலும் டீடைல்ஸ் தெரிஞ்சுக்கணும்னா கீழ இருக்கிற டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன்ல இருக்கிற லிங்கை கிளிக் பண்ணுங்க. எடுத்துருவோம் போல இருக்கு.
மீனாட்சி ஃபேக்கல்ட்டி ஆஃப் கேட்டரிங் அண்ட் ஹோட்டல் மேனேஜ்மெண்ட், வலசரவாக்கம், சென்னை. அட்மிஷன்ஸ் ஓபன் ஃபார் பிஎஸ்சி கோர்சஸ். அப்ளை நவ.
ரீ லுக்கிங் ஃபார் ஆல் யூர் ஹேர் அண்ட் ஸ்கின் ரிலேட்டட் ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ்? தி பெஸ்ட் சொல்யூஷன் கிளினிக். உடனடியாக விசிட் பண்ணுங்க. அமேசிங்கான எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் பெறுங்க.